Welcome to the island of Puerto Rico. Welcome to the island of champions. World champions like Wilfredo Gomez, Felix Trinidad, Yvonne Calderon, and Miguel Cotto. Welcome to Ring City, USA, where rising stars earn their stripes in crossroad fights, with careers on the line and Saturday night main events just a win away.
We are 3,000 miles away from Hollywood's Wild Card Boxing Club, where Ring City USA started last November. Tonight, we come to you live from the island of Puerto Rico, where boxing is more than a sport. It's an integral part of the island's culture. This is what the roundabout outside of Felix Pagan Pintor's boxing gym in Guanabo looked like last week. This is what it looks like tonight as Ring City USA rolls into town for a long-anticipated showdown between 154-pounders Sergey Bohachuk and Brandon Adams. And with the ring set up on the fountain in the roundabout, so glad you could join us here on Twitch. Bob Papa, along with two-time world champion Sean Porter. We're going to be in Puerto Rico three times in the month of March. And Sean, you know, when you think about Puerto Rico and the rich tradition that exists, it brings back a lot of memories. It kind of gets the juices flowing, doesn't it?
The juices are flowing. We've had fun so far tonight, and we're just getting started. It's been a beautiful time out here so far. Beautiful island. It's going to be a beautiful night of boxing.
Make sure you join us on NBCSN beginning at 10 p.m. Eastern for our televised card, including our main event at 154 pounds. Sergey Bohachuk taking on Brandon Adams. And this was a fight that was supposed to happen in December. Bohachuk tested positive for COVID-19, says he's 100%. It's going to be interesting to see what he has. 18-0 with 18 knockouts.
You know what? He was blessed enough to make it through this virus safely. He says he's 100%. Coach says he's 100%. One thing I know about Bohachuk, he's a worker, and that's what he has to do tonight in order to beat Brandon Adams, is come in here and go to work.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty interesting to see how Bohachuk handles Adams, who showed a lot of pressure in his last fight because he took on Sonny Duverson and really took care of business. He went out and was able to go after him in a big-time way, and Bohachuk's going to have to be a little bit more relaxed than that.
Listen, two rounds is all it took against Sonny Duverson. That's all it's supposed to take against a replacement fighter. So Brandon Adams handled his business that night, but he's got Sergey Bohachuk tonight, 18-0, 18 KOs. He's got a lot to do tonight in order to win this one.
All right, we're excited to be here on Twitch this evening. We're going to show you all the cards, so let's take a look at the rundown. You're going to get a look at some talented young prospects making their pro debut. Jorge Diaz squaring off against Felipe Munoz. Harold Laguna squaring off against Darwin Alvarez. How about that name, Fernando Vargas Jr., the son of former champ Fernando Vargas. He's at 1-0 taking on Salomon Flores. And our first fight getting set to come up. And hey, listen, it's pretty exciting. You have Jorge Diaz and Felipe Munoz both making their pro debut. And talk about that moment of truth when you're getting ready to make your pro debut.
A little different when you're at home. There's added energy, added nervousness and anxiety. These guys, they've been fighting for a long time. So even though this is their debut, we should expect them to come out here and look stellar tonight.
And you see all the protocols that are being taken place. The fighters, the trainers, everybody has their masks on. There's been testing. It's been one of those situations where every detail with Ring City USA, they've taken every precaution. No fans in attendance. Now, there are some fans in the neighborhood because we are in a roundabout, and this is normally a thoroughfare that people that live in the community use so they could stand on their side of the fence. They'll be loud here this evening.
That's right.
Daily temperature and symptom checks and masks being required to be worn at all times. So we are getting set for our first bout of the evening here on Twitch. Ring City USA from Puerto Rico, the first of three stops here in the month of March. Let's head it up to the ring for the introductions. Here's Lupe Contreras.
From El Gimnasio, Felix Pagan Pintor, Guaynabo City, Puerto Rico. Boxing is back on the island. Anyone, anytime, anywhere, this is Ring City USA. making the walk to the ring. In the blue corner, Felipe Muñoz.
So Felipe Muñoz, the first one to make his way out of the boxing gym, the Felix Pagan Pintor Boxing Gym here in Guaynabo, and trying to be relaxed, trying to take it easy. First fight as a professional. Don't want to rush it.
You know what you do, though. You treat everything the same. You come in here, you know, everything. The walk to the ring, the energy, everything has to be just like it was in the amateurs. And the way he performed then is how he should perform tonight.
So Muñoz making his pro debut. Steps into the ring for the first time as a professional. And I guess one of the things that he's got going in his favor is the fact that not only is he making his pro debut, but so is his opponent.
There you go. Yeah. They're both are stepping into new territories. And I'm sure they're both looking forward to making the best of this night. They both want to win, of course.
Across the ring, in the red corner, his opponent, Jorge Diaz.
A little more bounce from Jorge Diaz, whereas Muñoz kind of just walked in. At least Diaz is on his toes coming out a little bit, grooving to the music a little bit, Sean.
Listen, both these guys look good, and this is what Ring City USA is all about, competitive boxing. You rarely see two guys making their debuts. One guy's got to win this fight, you know? So somebody's going to lose their O really quickly in this one.
Yeah, two guys that are, you know, young prospects, but they're going to make their pro debut against each other. And Jorge Diaz steps into the ring. Four rounds at 147 pounds.
That's my weight.
Hey, he's not ready for you yet. Although if he looks good, he could be a guy that you could spar with.
I don't know. We'll see.
All right, so Diaz and Muñoz in the ring making their pro debuts. Now let's take a look at the tail of the tape for this first bout of the evening. Diaz, 20 years of age. Muñoz at 30 years of age and 146 pounds. Muñoz weighed in at 143. Diaz with the reach advantage, although Muñoz has the height advantage. Let's send it back up into the ring and Lupe Contreras.
We continue here on the island of Puerto Rico. It is Ring City USA, presented in association with Bash Boxing, Miguel Cotto Promotions, and H2 Entertainment. We start the action with this bout, set for a distance of four rounds in the welterweight division. At ringside, scoring the action, the judges are Ramon Solis, Luis Ruiz, and Gerardo Martinez. At the sound of the bell, the man in charge of the ring, referee Yanni Guzman. Presenting first, the fighter standing in the blue corner. He enters the ring, wearing white with red and black trim when he stepped on the scale. He weighed in at an official 146 pounds. Tonight, atop the canvas of Ring City USA, he is making his professional debut, representing Aguadilla, Puerto Rico, Felipe Muñoz. Across the ring in the red corner, wearing black with gold and white trim, he weighed in officially at 143 pounds, like his opponent, after an outstanding amateur career. Tonight, he makes his professional debut, representing Sidra, Puerto Rico, Jorge Diaz.
Vámonos. Okay, muchachos, ya yo leí las instrucciones en las esquinas. Vamos a hacer una pelea limpia. Esto está un poco alto. El golpe aquí es legal. Golpe aquí está bien. ¿Estamos claros? ¿Alguna pregunta?
No.
Choque en guante, te gana el mejor. Solís. Jerry.
All right, both guys making their pro debut. Jorge, the big time Diaz, 23 years of age, and Felipe Munoz making his pro debut at 31. Diaz trained by Juan de Leon, former trainer of heavyweight contender Joe Messi from Buffalo. Good exchange there to get things going here in round one.
Listen, you got four rounds. Your debut, we're going to see a lot more exchanges just like that right there.
Sean, what does it say about what you're trying to accomplish in your pro debut, putting the big time as your nickname on the back of your trunks?
You know, you know what? I think, first of all, you want to win the fight. But when you put big time on it, you're trying to tell everybody where you're trying to go. You know? I'm impressed by the 30-year-old so far, too, because I read into that. Okay, you got a guy turning pro relatively late, quote unquote, because he's turning pro at 30, but he's got a lot of fight in him.
Good right hand, though, by Diaz.
And a great uppercut, too, there, too.
Diaz with almost 190 amateur fights.
This is a good fight, good action so far, but I do have to say, Jorge Diaz is he's in the corner right now, but he's doing some good work in this first round.
Meanwhile, Munoz is losing some equipment.
Yeah. What I was going to say is Jorge's beating him out of his equipment, and then he's starting to get backed up, so I couldn't really pull the trigger on it.
You know, Diaz may be just 20 years old, but iron does sharpen iron. He gets to train and spar regularly with former two-division champion Jose the Sniper Pedraza, one of Puerto Rico's finest current boxers today.
And you know what I don't see from Felipe is a game plan. You know, he's obviously has some skill, but he's not displaying skill. He's obviously displaying the fight, what you need, but he's got to be able to have some skills in order to compete with Jorge.
Yanni Guzman is the referee for this first bout. And they're getting the equipment of Munoz tightened up.
They had to fix the equipment, but I got a feeling coach was giving them some rest.
Timing. But
it's the game within the game.
There you go. You know how it goes, Brian.
Sean, was the first round in your first professional bout kind of like a whirlwind for you?
It lasted all of, I think, 60 seconds. You know, I was on the platform saying you treat everything the same, and that's what I did in my debut. These guys, they're in for a competitive fight. Notice the energy here. Diaz is already off of the stool. He's ready for this second round to begin. He took control in this first round. You see a very good uppercut with the left hand and right over the top with the right hand. That was a good combination, slash great combination from Jorge Diaz there.
But
So round number two underway in this scheduled four rounder. Both boxers making their pro debut.
I don't know if you guys saw that, but Felipe put his head down, and now he's fighting. So this has become a dogfight for him. Now you see him hit late after the break. This is a dogfight already, just in two rounds.
And this is the kind of test you need early on for in your pro debut. Obviously, both of these fighters in their debut, but for Diaz, you need to have something crazy.
Oh! Down goes Munoz.
Three, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve.
Yep.
Pro debut of Jorge Diaz ends with a second round stoppage.
Listen, Brian was talking about a test in your first fight out. That was not the test that Felipe Munoz expected. Not at all. You want my headphones so you can say it?
Well, his nickname is the Big Time, and put on a big time performance in his pro debut.
I'll say it again, we got some time. I didn't see structure there. First fight, first pro fight, all that. Not as much structure as I expected to see from this young man, but he looked very good.
Worked the jab, then hooked him to the body. And then the left hand, boom. Munoz never saw it, Sean.
What you can't do, you can't go to the body with your head up. We'll get a good look at it right here. Felipe put him on the rope, so he thought he had control, but he was thrown to the body with his head straight up. And Jorge, I think he just was fighting back and found the perfect punch for him right there.
So for the 20-year-old who turns 21 on March the 23rd, right here in Puerto Rico, the pro debut ends successfully. Stopping Felipe Munoz in the second round. And the mouth guard's got big time on it. For the official time of the stoppage, we send it back up to Lupe Contreras.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Felix Pagan Pintor Gym, we have the official time, 42 seconds of round number two. Your winner, by way of knockout in his pro debut, Jorge Diaz.
So Jorge Diaz, with a big time start to his professional debut. Mentioned there's no fans in attendance, but doesn't stop you if you've got a house nearby to stand on the stairs and watch some live boxing. Sean, we'll take one more look at the knockout. And Jorge Diaz made Munoz pay for a big mistake.
Yeah, right there. Again, we've seen it a couple times now there, but a great counter hook. You know, when somebody goes to your body, you kind of, well, your mindset is block, block, and then return. And that is exactly what Jorge Diaz was able to do right there. Block, block, and then return, a big hook, and get the knockout.
So Jorge Diaz at 42 seconds of round number two with a knockout of Felipe Munoz. And Diaz getting set, again interviewed by Curran. We'll get to that in just a second. Of course, the protocol's in place. The ring is being cleaned, which happens in between each and every fight, as every safety precaution is being taken place. It takes about 5 to 7 minutes between each fight. Not only do they spray it with disinfectant, but then they'll have a crew come in and also wipe down the ropes and make sure that everything is up to specs. I guess you got to, like golf, you got to worry about the wind. You got to play the wind when you're spraying the ring.
I assure you, no one knew about that coming down here. No one knew wind was going to be a factor.
Sean, let's take a look at the highlights again from Jorge Diaz's win in his pro debut.
Yeah, I think that was the very first exchange. We're right here in the second round already. But a great exchange from Jorge. He was composed, went to the body, knew to stay to the body, keeps his hands up right there. And then again, the counter left hook is what caused that big knockout right there.
All right, so Jorge Diaz victorious in his pro debut as he stops Felipe Munoz at 42 seconds of round number two. Diaz victorious. The big time is with Kern.
The winner, Jorge Diaz. Jorge, congratulations. That was your pro debut, so you made quite a splash there, right?
Jorge, felicidades. Fue tu debut esta noche. Una presentación fantástica, ¿no?
Así es, una podía, sabía que podía ya terminar la pelea en el primer round, decidí trabajarlo un poco más y en el segundo pues vino la mano, pero lo primero que todo quiero darle gracias a Dios por la oportunidad y que mi rival no salió lastimado y que ambos salimos bien airosos.
Yeah, that's exactly where you went. It was a good performance. I thought I might be able to take him on the first round, but we worked a little bit. The punch came in the second, but first of all, I'd like to thank God, and everything came out great tonight.
You wanted to take him out in the first. You had to, unfortunately, wait for the second round. You grew up 45 minutes away from here. So what does it mean for you to be fighting where we are right now, 45 minutes away from home?
Tú básicamente es un local, vives como a 45 minutos de aquí. ¿Qué significa para ti pelear en casa?
Pues mira, más que nada agradecido. Esta pelea se la dedico a mi gente, a Puerto Rico, a mi familia, a mi equipo de trabajo. ¿Qué más puedo pedir?
Well, first of all, the one word that I have to go back to is I'm very grateful. I dedicate this fight to my people, to all my team, everyone I worked with, and really, what more can I say? I'm just grateful for this.
You wanted to take him out in the first round. It was eventually the second round where you found the left hook. What did you find there in the second round to give you that opening and to get that devastating knockout?
Lo querías terminar en el primer asalto, pero se fue a la segunda. Llegó el golpe. ¿Qué fue lo que viste para conectar ese gancho?
Pues mira, decidí trabajar el primer round más mayormente para saber qué error él hacía. En el segundo, pues ya sabía que él bajaba mucho esa mano y coloqué mi mano y pues vino el knockout.
I wanted to work a little bit. I want to see what errors he performed. I saw that he was dropping that hand, so the second round came around. I connected the hook. Things ended there.
And like we said, this was your debut, 147 pounds at welterweight. We know another very well-known welterweight from Puerto Rico is, of course, Miguel Cotto. He's here tonight. He's achieved a lot in boxing. What do you hope to achieve in the sport?
Obviamente, tú peleas en el peso welter, uno de los más reconocidos welters del mundo. Miguel Cotto está presente aquí. ¿Qué quieres lograr tú en tu carrera profesional como welter?
Pues mira, primero que nada, ser una persona, una mejor persona y pues ser campeón mundial, que ese es el sueño de todo atleta que quiere lograr y ayudar a la gente. Yo vengo de abajo y sé lo que es trabajar para llegar a donde estoy ahora mismo.
First and foremost, I want to be a good person. I know what it takes to get to where you have to be. I started from the bottom and I want to represent the people. I want to help them out and that's really my goal. Whatever comes after that, that's just icing on the cake.
Started from the bottom, and now you're here. Jorge Diaz, congratulations on your first professional win.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jorge Diaz turned pro tonight in Puerto Rico and wins with a second-round knockout. Counter left off the body shot, takes care of business, dropping and putting out Felipe Munoz. Speaking of knockouts, Sergey Bohachuk has 18 of them. In 18 pro fights. Just chilling, relaxing. He'll be fighting in the main event this evening on Ring City USA, taking on Brandon Adams. And this fight was supposed to happen in December. Bohachuk tested positive for COVID-19, but they're ready to go tonight.
Serhi Boachuk.
I won this fight, I'm hungry.
Versus Brandon Adams.
The pressure is just to win.
The fight we wanted in December, it's even a bigger fight tonight.
I'm my hard puncher.
It's time to tape them up, lace them up, and let your fists do the talking.
I don't plan on bringing anything short of greatness. Yeah. Come on,
come on. Brandon, keep your hand up. I will hit you hard.
Do I think I can knock him out? I know I can knock him out.
It's time for the main event on Ring City, USA.
That's the main event, and you'll see it on NBCSN beginning at 9 p.m. Eastern. We'll start things off with Danielito Zuria taking on Ruslan Aliyev. And the main event, Serhi Boachuk taking on Brandon Adams, should be exciting. So we're getting set for our next bout of the evening. And this one at 140 pounds as we send it back up to Lupe.
We continue here at the Felix Pagan Pintor Gym. Now entering the ring, out of the blue corner, Darwin Alvarez.
Darwin Alvarez, 32 years of age, also making his pro debut this evening.
I gotta say, a little unorthodox night with these guys making pro debuts in their 30s. Nothing wrong with it. I'm just saying. You don't say it too, you don't see it too often.
30 is the new 20, let's be honest.
There you go.
So while Alvarez at 32 is making his pro debut, he'll actually be 33 on May the 4th. I think everybody's looking forward to see what Harold Laguna has to offer at 21 years of age. Great to be here in Puerto Rico. Who is the greatest Puerto Rican fighter of all time? Here are your choices on Twitter at RingCityUSA. That's just four because the poll could only fit four.
Yeah, Bob, don't let Ivan Calderon see this poll as he's walking around here, a decorated former champion.
He doesn't know about it. He was full of smiles when I saw him. He doesn't know about it.
How about Wilfredo Benitez?
There you go.
All right, back up to the ring, and Lupe Contreras.
Across the ring, in the red corner, Harold Laguna.
Harold Laguna just turned 21 back on January the 24th. Made his professional debut on February the 15th. First round knockout of Jonathan Guzman.
Listen, as a fighter, as a competitor, I'm grateful to USA, to Ring City USA right now. They brought this right here in everyone's backyard. What? And they're giving us something we haven't heard in over a year now.
And this is quite literally Harold Laguna's back here.
There you go.
Well, how about the fact that Laguna's family actually rented a house just off the property, and they got the backyard loaded up to see him in his second pro fight.
Boom.
And there you get a look at the house behind us.
Bob, I'll have what they're having. That's an energetic group over there.
A little Wrigley Field feel to it with people on the roofs. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape for our next bout of the evening at 140 pounds. Scheduled for four rounds. Harold Laguna, 21 years of age. Alvarez, 32. Laguna weighed in at 135.2 pounds. Alvarez with a slight height and reach advantage. Time for the formal introductions. Here's Lupe Contreras.
We continue with the action. This is Ring City USA, presented in association with Best Boxing, Miguel Cotto Promotions, and H2 Entertainment. This bout set for a distance of four rounds or less in the super lightweight division. Our judges are Ramon Solis, Luis Ruiz, and Gerardo Martinez. At the sound of the bell, the ref in charge of the action, Ramon Peña, presenting first. The fighter fighting out of the blue corner. He steps in wearing red with white trim. On the scale, he registered an official weight of 138.75 pounds. And tonight, atop the Ring City USA canvas, he is making his professional debut. Fighting out of Toa Alta, Puerto Rico, Darwin Alvarez. Across the ring in the red corner, wearing blue with red and black trim. On the scale, he weighed in at an official 135.25 pounds. Tonight, he enters the ring for the second time as a pro with a record of one victory and one KO. Guaynabo City, Puerto Rico, presente Harold Big Time Laguna.
Laguna está con principal. Ok, chicos, ustedes son dos profesionales, ya recibieron las instrucciones de sus esquinas. Recuerden protegerse en todo momento y respetar mis comandos. Toquemos guantes y Dios les bendiga.
So, Laguna and Alvarez getting set to start.
Ready, Rui.
And Brian,
ready,
I mean, it's one
ready,
thing
ready,
to have the hometown advantage, but Laguna is literally fighting in his backyard.
Even with quarantine social distancing, this guy brings a home crowd. You got to love that.
Listen, I hope this goes more than one round because I want more of that, what I just heard. Comes out sharp on the jab and some combinations. It's a good jab by Darwin, too.
Laguna targeting that body, Sean, early.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of guys have a tendency to fight with the amateur pace when they first turn pro. So, I mean, we're seeing a lot of combinations from Laguna right off of the bat. And there's no surprise there because this is his debut.
Sean, it's one thing to make your pro debut and you got family and friends there, but when you're actually in your hometown, in the neighborhood, I would think that's something you got to manage if you're Laguna a little bit.
You know, there's a lot of things that separate being an amateur from a pro, but to me, at the end of the day, you have to carry that same type of energy and excitement. And so I got a feeling that this is nothing new to him. It's just new from the standpoint of not having a headgear on, smaller gloves, and things like that. Nothing new, though, man. I mean, when my whole purpose when I turned pro, I just wanted to entertain people. That was it. So he's got a prime opportunity right here. I feel like Darwin's, he's a little hurt. I think he's hurt to the body, too. Starting to plod a little, you know, very, very quickly in this fight. You know, just the first round, he's plodding already.
Those body punches have slowed down his output considerably.
There's another left and right to the body. Scored by Laguna. Oh, and the left hook, and then one to the chin as Alvarez was going down.
Cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez.
Just like that.
Great body work there. He was just looking for mercy. He wanted to just take a knee. And then he caught one on his way down. Unfortunately, he caught one on his way down, and I think he decided that he wanted to just finish it. No more, no mercy. Let's just finish this. Look at him. That's what I'm talking about.
Shout out to the DJ playing the 90s hit, Sean. I know you can get down with some snow.
Yeah,
right now.
Yeah. Where'd that come from? Jim Carrey did a parody of this song. I love it. Great night so far, fellas. Great night.
There's the Laguna family and friends having a fun night.
Two fights on this card so far. Two fighters nicknamed the Big Time, both victorious. Starting a trend earlier.
Laguna's nickname is the Big Time?
Yeah.
Huh.
Really cool scene. Guanabo, Puerto Rico, Ring City, USA. And Harold Laguna improves to 2-0, two stoppages. Well, Sean, once again, see a young boxer not forgetting about going to the body.
Yeah, and a young gay, young kid right out of the gate throwing combinations. Looks good throwing them too, but right here we'll see him go right back to the body. Look, mercy and then no mercy. Yeah, it happens. Great work by Laguna. From the beginning of the fight to the end of the fight. I mean, he came out throwing combinations, trying to establish his rhythm, his flow, establish he's going to win this fight. That's exactly what he did.
Right, left, boom. That was it for Alvarez. The one on the chin, I don't think was the determining factor.
And he was hurt from at the to the body earlier on in the fight. And I think a lot of times you're able to kind of walk around the ring and recover. But at that point, your back's against the ropes. You got nowhere to go. He felt that last one, Alvarez, and he said, that's it.
Great opportunity for Harold Laguna. So two fights in the less than a month. For the official time of the stoppage, here's Lupe.
From El Gimnasio Felix Pagan Pintor, Guaynabo, Puerto Rico, referee Ramon Peña calls a halt to the action with an official time of 2 minutes, 10 seconds of the opening round. Your winner, by way of knockout, Guaynabo, Puerto Rico presente, El Barbero, Harold Laguna.
Turned 21 in January, made his pro debut in February, and he kicks off March with his second win as a pro and a stoppage as well. And the pro debut for Darwin Alvarez didn't go as planned.
Sean, you talked about being able to change over quickly from the amateur style to the pro style in just your first, or in this case, second pro fight. You know, I really love from Laguna, not just the poise, but very crisp shots. Had a 3-inch reach deficiency against his opponent, yet you never saw that become a factor. And as we've been harping on, went to the body early to set a very strong tone.
Yeah, I think going to the body was just the rhythm of, again, even in the amateurs, we throw body shots. And so it's like, you know, you go to the head, you go to the body, and you work up and down. You know, that's a great fighter works accordingly, which is up and down, and you mix it up. And he went down to the body and found some success, and he continued to stay there. It was great.
So as the officials, the fighters, the trainers, our camera people exit the ring, once again, the cleaning protocols in full swing. 5 to 7 minutes to get the ring cleared out. And we'll take one more look at Harold Laguna dusting off Darwin Alvarez at 210 of round number one. Don't let that baby face fool you. Some devastating body shots.
He looked good, came out fast, start fast. Second pro fight, start fast. You see there, he went to the body already. He knew what he wanted to do in this fight. He knew he needed to put his punches together. And that hook right there was just him simply fighting. You know, it wasn't him trying to be dirty or anything like that. He caught Alvarez on his way down. Little, you see that? A little bit of a bulldoze, you know? Put his top of his head, the crown of his head into the chest of Alvarez and pushed him back. So that's a pro tactic.
So Harold Laguna victorious in his second pro fight, and he's standing by with Kern.
I'm here with the winner, Harold Laguna. Harold, congratulations. You're now 2-0 with two knockouts. What did you find there in that first round to get the victory?
Harold, felicidades. Vas 2-0 con dos knockouts. ¿Qué fue lo que viste en ese primer asalto para conseguir la victoria?
Bueno, pues empecé con calmita, entonces vi que estaba cogiendo un poquito ya de confianza. Me metí un cabezazo, nos dimos un cabezazo sin querer. Entonces tuve que recurrir a noquearlo.
I was just working steady. I could see that he was getting a little bit overconfident there. I found my spot, and I just kept going forward. I got headbutted by accident and didn't want that to go any further, so I stopped the fight at that point.
And because of the global pandemic, right now everything is closed off to fans in most places. That is the situation here in Puerto Rico. But your family and friends decided to do something creative, right? There's a house over here, and your father rented it all out, and they're all here supporting you, right?
Por cuestión de la pandemia, obviamente no hay público, pero tu familia encontró forma de verte pelear. Cuéntanos qué fue lo que sucedió.
Sí, pues, con esto de la pandemia, pues, se paró todo. Tuve un año ya sin pelear. Entonces, mi primera pelea, gracias a Dios, tuve bastante fanaticada de mi barrio. Y ya para esta, pues, dijeron que no podía haber público. Y, pues, mi familia se movió y consiguieron una casita. Y ahí están todos juntos, reunidos, pues, apoyándome la gente del barrio.
Yeah, my first fight, on my pro debut, I had basically my whole neighborhood there. And due to the pandemic, I hadn't fought in a while. But my family, they put their heads together and they rented a house right here, right across the parking lot. And they all joined in and they're all watching me here in my second pro bout.
Only your second pro fight. Now, usually if it's a pandemic, you don't have people. Your family's here. Any extra nerves? Was that tough to have them here knowing that they're going to watch your fight?
Típicamente con la pandemia no hay público. ¿Te dio más nervios o te da tranquilidad tenerlos aquí?
No, con esta la pandemia pues estuve más nervioso que la primera pelea. De verdad estuve con mucho estrés encima durante esta semana.
I felt a lot of stress actually with the pandemic going on. That made me a bit nervous. This entire week I was kind of stressed out, but yeah, it did make a difference.
And you actually grew up not too far from here and you had this fight in this venue. What does it mean for you to fight so close to home?
Obviamente eres local de aquí de Guaynabo, no vives muy lejos de aquí. ¿Qué significa para ti pelear en tu propia casa, la de Guaynabo City?
Pues un orgullo grande estar aquí en mi pueblo representando y estamos muy contentos, muy felices más con esta victoria que logramos.
Obviously I'm very proud. I'm glad to represent my hometown here and more than happy with this victory, but most of all I'm proud.
So the question obviously now is what next? You're at 140 pounds, it's a red hot division. And it looks like by what you're wearing here, you have big plans. You got the logo already. You got the color scheme. So I'm sure you have big plans in boxing. What's next for you?
Obviamente peleas en las 140 libras. Una división con mucha competición. Obviamente traes el uniforme representando a Puerto Rico. ¿Cuáles son tus planes para el futuro?
Bueno, pues se supone que sea el peso 130. Lo que pasa que no hay peleador y pues tenemos que recurrir a subir de peso. Y mi plan es seguir boxeando y si Dios quiere ser campeón mundial. Eso lo dejo en las manos de Dios.
Well, actually, I had to come up a weight class because of the pandemic. There were no fighters willing to fight. So I want to go down to 130, and 130, that's the plan. I want to see what I can find there. And obviously, the goal for everyone is to become a world champion.
Mi peso es 130 como tal.
My weight is 130.
Harold, congratulations on your second pro victory. Bob, back to you.
Felicidades.
Gracias.
All right, thank you very much, Kern. So Harold Laguna. One more look at the stoppage in round number one. Coming up with a right to the body, boom, left, and down went Alvarez and could not answer the count. So Laguna improves to 2-0, two stoppages, family and friends on hand. Could he become a future star in Puerto Rico? We've asked this question via Twitter. Ring City Twitter handle, at Ring City USA. Who's the greatest Puerto Rican fighter of all time? Right now, Felix Trinidad, Tico, leading in the balloting in the polls. You, the fans, get to weigh in on it. We'll keep that open throughout the course of the evening, but Trinidad has the lead. But as we said, they could put a lot more than four names in there if they could handle it.
Sean, talk about a finisher in the great Felix Trinidad, the former welterweight, junior middleweight champion. How about Danilito Zorrilla, who we're going to see tonight? Body type-wise, the way he sets up that left hook, very Tito-esque.
Yeah, I agree. Very Tito-esque. I love the way you put that. His body frame, I mean, the way he throws his punches, his style, it all is very Tito-esque, and I like him.
You can see the influences here. Very
absolutely,
well done.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Speaking of the influences, You see the flashy robe right there. Well, guess who his last name is? Vargas. That's Fernando Vargas Jr. You know who his dad is.
Who's
Fernando
that?
Vargas.
Yeah.
Taking on Salome Flores Torres in an 8-round middleweight bout. But Fernando Vargas Jr. getting set for his second professional fight. Made his pro debut on December the 18th of 2020 in Mexico.
Kid looks good.
Yeah, well, he's got the flash. Look, and there's his pop.
Junior's Junior's clearly got the flash of the El Ferocious father, but he's also got some humility. Very, very nice young kid to talk to. You can really see how much growing up, not in the shadow of his father, but growing up and really seeing and learning from his father, he's sort of got that next level poise already that you would want in a young fighter.
He's very mature at 24 years old, and like you said, a lot of flash too, which is going to pay dividends for him.
Well, we're getting ready to look at Fernando Vargas Jr. take center stage. For more on the Vargas family, let's send it to Kern.
It's never easy to be the son of a legend, but for Fernando Vargas Jr., he wants to embrace what made his dad special, but at the same time, he would like to carve his own path.
I never desired boxing, but I knew and I understood if I was gonna do it and take it serious, I'd have to give it my whole life. My dad has missed birthdays, he's missed Christmases because of camp and because of boxing, what it requires. My mom thought it stopped when my dad was fighting, but now all her sons fight. I feel sorry for her, but I feel if our family and our loved ones see us doing our part, you know, they could be a little more at ease.
You know, people say, do you get nervous? I go, I don't get nervous because I know what my kids can do. It's a beautiful thing, me living what I'm living with my kids right now. The experiences that I'm doing, that I'm experiencing today as a father, as a trainer, I live that through their eyes.
I really want to be able to show that this junior takes his role serious and wants to compete with the highest level. I've been sparring with Terrell Goucher, 2012 Olympian. Bochuk also has been helping me out and just mature as a fighter, so it's easier said than done, but I'm looking to push myself mentally, you know, physically and emotionally just to go to new levels and to continue to grow.
Fernando Vargas Sr. actually has three sons who all box, but the oldest is the namesake, Fernando Vargas Jr., and he's 24 years old. He's looking to follow in his father's footsteps and achieve what he could achieve with the same amount of swag as well. Back to you, Bob.
Well, he certainly got some swag, and as his father said during our fighter interviews, he told us, you know what, the one thing my son is an exceptional athlete. And he goes, and we'll see that in the ring.
Played AAU basketball at a very high level, played football, played soccer. That sort of set the table athletically for the fighter he was going to become. And Sean, when he told us, I never wanted necessarily to be a boxer. That was my dad's thing. It was sort of seeing him in the gym when Senior would put him in there and spar in a gym he owns in Las Vegas against up-and-coming kids. He would see the power of his son. He said, hey, maybe you want to get into this after all.
Yeah, Let's set it back up to the ring in Lupe.
Now, making his way into the ring, out of the blue corner, Salome Flores.
Salome Flores Torres, 36 years of age, 0-2 in his career, from El Salvador.
He's got a strong look to him. Walking mean, he's walking strong. Gotta be strong against a junior.
Yeah, well, he's 0-2, and he's never made it to the third round. So we'll see what he does tonight. Back up to Lupe.
Across the ring, in the red corner, Fernando Vargas Jr.
Unlike his dad, who had an extensive amateur career, Brian, Fernando Vargas Jr., not a deep amateur background, but that's because he was playing all those other sports and involved in other sports, a more cross-trained athlete.
Yeah, as you can see, at age 24, just his second pro fight. Took him a couple years, like we mentioned earlier, to figure out that this sport was for him. But not only did he show the power early that let his dad know we've got something here, it's some of that poise that we talked about before, and just overall, plus athleticism, something even dad didn't have coming up the ranks.
So both fighters in the ring. And let's take a look at the tail of the tape for Fernando Vargas Jr., 24 years of age, weighing in just under 160. Torres at 162 pounds. Vargas has the height advantage. We are getting set for our next bout. Both men are in the ring, ready to go as we send it back up to Lupe.
We continue with the action here at Gimnasio. Félix Pagán Pintor, Guaynabo, Puerto Rico. This is Ring City USA, presented in association with Bash Boxing and 360 Promotions. This bout set for a distance of four rounds or less in the super middleweight division. Our judges scoring at ringside are Ramon Solis, Luis Ruiz, and Gerardo Martinez. At the sound of the bell, the ref in charge of the action, Gianni Guzman. Presenting first, the fighter fighting out of the blue corner. He enters wearing blue with white trim. His official weight, 162 pounds. Tonight, he enters the ring in search of his first pro victory with a record of two losses. Fighting out of Santa Ana, El Salvador, Salome Flores. Across the ring, the red corner, wearing black with orange trim, he weighed in officially at 159¾ pounds. Tonight, he enters the ring for the second time as a pro, looking to remain undefeated with one victory and one KO. The blood of a legendary world champion courses through his veins. With the KO in his DNA from Oxnard, California, and now fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, the ferocious one, Fernando El Fero Vargas Jr.
Rémelo, vámonos. Fernando. Ok, muchachos, ya leí las instrucciones en las esquinas. Vamos a hacer una pelea limpia, choque en guante y ganar mejor.
You know, sometimes you see fighters who are the sons of famous dads carry a lot of pressure, but it feels like Fernando Vargas Jr. is comfortable in where he's at. Now, he's not trying to prove anything. He's just trying to do what he thinks he does best.
Kind of a little bit of a blessing and a curse. The blessing is he started late or doesn't have the amateur pedigree that his dad did, so he's in love with it, and he's in love with being himself. He's not intimidated by trying to live up to his dad. The other side of it is, you know, he's a little bit behind. And he's, you know, a little bit playing catch up. But looks good doing it. He's a southpaw, great jab, great boxing ability, and you know, a good eye for this in the ring as well. Two counter straight counter lefts, and then there you go. And then now he hooked it that time because he saw the opening will be a little bit wider, will be a wider punch. Whoa.
Right hand hurt.
Time.
Salome Flores.
What? golpe bajo.
He's saying a low blow.
I didn't see it.
Cógelo con calma, tiene 5 minutos. Dámelo 5. It's not your fault. It's not your fault. But it's a low blow, all right? It's not intentional. It's illegal, all right?
Let's take a look at it again.
Yeah, let's see it. Okay, it was,
yeah.
It was really low. I've never seen a punch that low.
It's not often you punch at the kneecaps.
Oh,
in this
Lordy.
Game.
That one was low.
Get as much time as you want to recover.
But.
Now he's shook up, so a straight 1-2 is going to land. And just about anything he wants to do now, Fernando can do.
Vargas is a big kid. He's got good speed, and you're seeing he is landing flush with those left hands.
1-2 down the middle, right? You step in with it. There you go, good.
I heard his dad say 1-2 right down the middle, step in with it, and he did.
I hear fantastic information coming from his dad.
Jab 3-2. Good. Watch him up, bro. Just straight punches. Straight punches. Straight punches. Straight punches. Put the measure on him. There it is.
Oh, left hand down goes Flores.
Good, son. Nice and smart, puppy. Cinco. Nice and smart.
Seis. Hear that? Nice and smart.
Ocho. Alza las manos. Straight punches down the middle. ¿Está bien? Straight punches down the middle, son. Camina. Okay.
Straight punches
down the middle. Don't.
Good feint.
Measure first. There you go, right there. Look for it. There it is. Good. Keep his chin down. Good. Straight punches. 1-2 down the middle, right to his chest.
If you're Torres, fight back or move.
1-2 down.
He's showing hard.
Don't, yeah, don't stand there and wait for it. Fight back and then move.
2-3-2. Good. Good.
It's hard for Vargas to miss at this point. He goes down again, and the referee's going to stop it.
Yeah, that's it.
Good finishing instincts from the kid. El Feroz indeed.
Yeah, that was Feroz. Yes, that was ferocious right there. Very good. Very good second fight for him.
Good job by referee Yanni Guzman, too.
Yeah.
Yep.
I always tell people the refs, they have a hard job. The judges have a hard job because they have to judge the fight. But when a punch is blatantly that low, for the ref to have that kind of patience and understanding there, I have a lot of respect for the ref to handle it the way that he did.
Fernando Vargas Jr. improves to 2-0, gets his second stoppage.
Is that dad on his arm right there crying?
Yeah. That's dad taking his gloves off.
Is he celebrating or is he crying? What was he doing?
he's doing both right now. I'll tell you that. He's a happy, proud father.
He lives in Vegas with me. I got some jazz for him next time I see him.
So we're going to take a look at the first knockdown.
This first one had me confused because the right hook that he hit him with barely touched him. We may not see it from this angle. Oh. That's that knockdown, not the low blow.
That one touched him.
Yeah, that one touched him.
There it is.
Look at that, straight 1-2. Straight, beautiful 1-2. And dad was saying, step into it. You, when you step with your punches, you close the distance and you also bring power with it.
So the former champ, Fernando Vargas, watching his eldest son take care of business and finishing off Salome Flores. For the official time of the stoppage, here's Lupe Contreras.
Here at Gimnasio Felix Pagan Pintor, referee Johnny Guzman determines the blue corner can no longer continue, obligating him to stop this contest with an official time of 2 minutes 13 seconds of the opening round, declaring the winner by way of technical knockout, still undefeated, the ferocious one, Fernando Vargas Jr.
You know, Sean, there's different ways too, right? You're bringing guys along, okay? Here is a guy that has limited amateur experience in Fernando Vargas Jr. He's 24 years of age. So you're getting some work in there. Again, someone that he clearly has more skill than, better than a 36-year-old guy who's 0-2, as opposed to if you had a guy coming through the amateur ranks with a lot of experience and maybe a world champion or Olympian, you're looking for different markets.
You know, the important thing for the Vargas family is that they understand they shouldn't fast track him and put him in the ring with guys who may outmatch him because they have more experience, amateur or pro. Take those same steps into becoming the world champion the way his dad did. Do it a little bit differently because you don't have exactly what your dad had in terms of your pedigree. But at the same time, dad knows who I have in my son. My son's an athlete. I know when the time's right, and the time will be right, and they'll go for it.
Hey, look at the end of the fight again. And Vargas with that right hand to the ear. Left hand to the chest. And then that one bounced off the top of the head, and that was it. And the referee did a good job to end the fight at 2:13 of round number one. Fernando Vargas Jr. improves to 2-0, gets his second stoppage. Embarking upon a career as a professional boxer. And with dad by his side. Guys, Fernando Sr., take a look at Oxnard, California, 26-5 with 22 knockouts, two-time super welterweight champion, became the youngest of all time, had the rivalry with De La Hoya. In fact, Fernando Vargas Jr. and Oscar's son are like the best of buddies. They're good friends, Brian.
Devin Vargas, yeah, or Devin De La Hoya, you don't find that, but what that relationship did was help Senior and Oscar repaired their relationship. Obviously, their junior middleweight title fight, one of the most explosive we've seen in the past few decades.
Now Fernando's got three sons involved in the sport. Well, dad and son are standing by, and Kern's ready to go. Kern?
I'm here with Fernando Vargas Jr. and Senior. Only your second pro fight, second. And I know you wanted to impress. How do you feel about your performance tonight?
I feel good. You know, we didn't get the knockout, but we got the TKO, so that'll have to do. But I just plan on getting better. I plan on getting better with each and every fight. I know I hurt him with some shots. I know he felt my punching power. But, yeah, with every fight, I'm going to continue to just, you know, grow and listen to my father.
And Senior, we heard you in the corner. You said straight punches down the middle. It was over and over.
Yeah.
Did he execute on your game plan?
Yeah, absolutely. I told him straight punches down the middle. You know, he's throwing straight punches. The left hand, he has a very powerful left hand. So I know that once they start feeling it, it's going to be a, you know, quick night, or it's going to be a long night for the guy that's going to be able to take him. So, because sooner or later, they're going to be able to take him. But, you know, they're going to be, you know, getting hurt with them.
And in the first round, there was a low blow.
Yeah.
Your opponent regained his composure, and he actually landed a couple right hands. Did you feel those at all in round one?
I didn't really feel them, honestly. But I didn't mean to go low on that. It was part of the exchanges. You know, my dad knows I'm not a dirty fighter. But I do apologize for that. I in no way wanted to hit him low like that. So, definitely, like I said, this is my second pro fight, and I plan to continue to grow.
And Senior, he's only 24 years old. The other day we were watching tape of you as a 21-year-old. Are you seeing any of yourself in your son
Absolutely.
Here?
Absolutely. You know, there's his boxing ability, you know, his intelligence. You know, I know that that's part of his DNA. So I'm very proud of him. He did amazing today. I know he's his own worst critic. So he's going to be, you know, he's going to be like, Dad, I could have done that. I could have done this. I could have done that. But this is only second pro fight, and he didn't have a long amateur career. He definitely, you know, stayed focused and did what he needed to do to win the fight.
And the other day we looked at highlights of your fight. So now we're going to look at highlights of your fight here. And we're going to break it down.
Okay.
We're going to get those queued up. Okay. We have a monitor down there.
Excuse me. Can you pick up the monitor? Monitor.
And we're going to get it right here on this monitor right here. Okay, here we go. Here's highlights. So talk me through what you see here and right here. Talk me through this right here.
I just thought he was just feeling the accumulation of the punches. We were looking for the knockout, you know, but TKO is okay.
We're gonna re-cue those highlights because we want to get your analysis. Okay. We want to get your father's analysis.
Okay.
So here we go, one more time. Talk me through what happened here.
Yeah, I was establishing my jab. I pulled back, threw a left hand. Just trying to get my distance. I know he found my left hand right there. 1-2 down the middle. Right here, the exchange is good with the hook. I didn't really land, but he fought that punch. Yeah. So, and that's all she wrote.
And Dad, I know that in the beginning, you were hesitant to have your son's box, right? But you said that if they buy in 100%, you would like them to continue. Happy with his performance? You want him
to continue? Absolutely. This is what I'm going to grow him as a fighter, as a professional. Like I said, my son doesn't have that pedigree of amateur experience that I did and that other fighters have, you know, other world champions. So he's learning on the job, but he's, you know, we've been sparring with great sparring, gold medalists and world champions, and that's only going to make him excel as a fighter. So I'm very proud of what he did today. You can see he did his job. What was his job? To get this guy out of here, right? The guy wasn't the most talented fighter in the world, but at the end of the day, he did what he needed to do. Now imagine if he didn't do that, if he wasn't able to get the guy out of there. So how bad would that be? So he did what he needed to do, and the guy served his purpose, and now we're on to the next one.
And this was a great opportunity for you on a big stage, only your second pro fight. So what's next for you?
You know, I don't want to say too much, but you know, there's some things in the works right now. But like I said, we're going to listen to my team right now. Tom Lauffer is advising us and working with us, so we're going to take it one fight at a time. And it's back to the gym for me. And whenever we get the call, we'll be ready to go.
Fernando, congratulations on a great performance. Hope to see you soon.
Appreciate it.
Bob, back to you.
Fernando Vargas Jr. 2-0, two stoppages, and he got some work in the gym with someone that we're going to see tonight in our main event on NBCSN, the man that will be fighting this man, Brandon Adams, who was very impressive with his second-round stoppage of Sonny Duverson in December on Ring City USA at the Wildcard Boxing Club in Los Angeles. Once again, fighting in our main event here in Puerto Rico, and he'll be taking on Sergey Boachuk.
Boachuk and Vargas have the same advisor, Tom Loeffler, a guy who had been instrumental behind the careers of the Klitschko brothers. Gennady Golovkin did bring him in for some sparring to try to mimic what Brandon Adams does best, the switching of stances, the speed and the quickness. We'll find out later tonight in the main event how Adams can hold up with the power of Boachuk. 18-0, 18 KOs.
And the fight was supposed to happen in December, but Sergey tested positive for COVID-19, but we are excited to see it tonight here on Ring City USA in Puerto Rico. Scheduled for 10 rounds, Boachuk and Adams. Sean had a chance to catch up with Brandon Adams at the fighter meetings the other day, talking about this fight finally coming to pass.
Hi, I'm Showtime Sean Porter. I'm sitting here with main event fighter Brandon the Cannon Adams. Down here in sunny Puerto Rico, my man, how you feeling?
I'm feeling good, excited, ready, just ready to go.
Very good. I want to go back real quick. December, you fight Sonny Duverson, live, NBC. What did you take from that fight, that big knockout that you had in the second round?
Looking at that fight, what I was able to do was show the world a little bit more of what I was capable of doing. Because it's been a while since I fought, 500 plus days since I've been active, I just wanted to prove to myself.
Yeah, it did not look like you had any ring rust at all. Moving forward, you got the guy who you were supposed to have in December, Sergey Boachuk. What can we expect from that fight?
A guy following another guy, and I'll just be leading him on straight to a bunch of right hands and left hooks.
It's like that, huh?
Yeah.
What is your message to all the fans out there that are looking forward to this fight? What would you tell them?
The statement, protect yourself at all times, you know, in and out the ring, is real important to me. And, you know, I'm blessed to be in the position that I'm in today. I've done everything that I possibly can do to make it to this platform right here. So whatever happened yesterday, it paved today.
Yeah.
It helped mold and grow me into the person that I am today, so I can be a better person tomorrow.
Well put, my man. As always, God bless you and good luck. Right here with the main event fighter, Brandon the Cannon Adams. I'm Showtime Sean Porter. Sergey Boachuk versus Brandon Adams, a fight you do not want to miss.
We are looking forward to seeing it tonight on NBCSN. It all gets underway at 9 p.m. Eastern from Puerto Rico. We'll be here three times in the month of March. Take a look at the fight card. We're going to get a look at Puerto Rican prospect Danielito Zoria taking on Ruslan Madiev. And Brian, Zoria is someone that people here in Puerto Rico are putting a lot of emphasis behind.
El Zorro, he calls himself. Not just the emphasis behind him because he's a good-looking prospect, another one in that lineage of potential great Cuban superstars, but this is somebody Miguel Cotto himself has handpicked, worked out with, brought him up under Cotto Promotions, sort of mentorship that you can see. There's a swagger with Zoria. There's a quality and a craft at a young age in what he does in the ring. This will be a very good test against Madiev.
Well, we are all fired up for our three fights, including our main event, Sergey Bohachuk and Brandon Adams in a 10-round super welterweight bout, all part of Ring City USA, live from Guaynabo, Puerto Rico. We'll be here three times in the month of March in this very historic setting with such a rich fight tradition. Over 60 world champions from this island. And make sure you join us live on Twitch after our main event. Tune in for the debut of Ring City USA Inside the Ropes with highlights and recap of tonight's event, plus live fan interaction. So you get a chance to ask Sean and Brian questions. Make sure you join us on NBCSN at 9 p.m. Eastern.